Hello all, many a times in our flipped classrooms, we need to make certain presentations, brochures, videos, lesson plans and also the certificates for our students. So one such app or software which comes very handy in making all this is our Canva. So today, using Canva, we would be looking at how we can make the presentations, videos, certificates and the lesson plans and make our classes actually fun. So for that, we'll type in our browser Canva and we need to open this canva.com. The first thing that you will need to do is you will need to sign up if you are using it for the first time. But as I am already signed up here, so this is the home page of Canva. Now, anything that you need to search, you can simply type it here. Or you can search it from this template also. But I know what I need, so I will type lesson plan here. So as soon as I click on lesson plan, I have various lesson plans that are already there. I can just click on the lesson plan that I want and I would be redirected to this other window where I can do all the editing to my this lesson plan, because this is the lesson plan which is a pre-decided one. I need to change the name of the teacher. So I'll just click there and I will write my name over here. Similarly, in the days when I need to add something, I can click on the text because I need to add certain text. I'll click on the heading or subheading depending upon the font that you want. And you see that subheading has come here. You can just use these this symbol and you can drag it over here. You can bring it to Monday. You can increase the size also if you want to do. And we can simply click here and we can mention the topic that we would be doing on Monday. Similarly, if I want to add for Tuesday, I will again click the subheadings. I'll click on add a subheading and I can again drag it here and I can mention mutual funds. So like this, I can fill up everything. I can also insert the images and then I can download it. You can either download it or you can also share it with your students. So when I download it, the only version that is available with me is the PDF version. I'll click on that. And the PDF of this particular lesson plan is available. You can see it here. This is how the PDF of the lesson plan would appear. And you can simply attach it to your Google Classroom so that the students know what all would be covered in this particular week. You can also share it with the students. So if you want to share this, what you have to do is you have to remember that as soon as you click on the share button, it says share a link to edit. So if you don't uncheck this, then the students would be able to edit it. I don't want that to happen. I just want that the students should be able to view this. So I will click on share a link to view. When I change this, I can copy the link and I can send it to my students. And they can simply open this using their phones also. So this is how we can create a lesson plan. Now let us go back to home and see how various presentations can be made. So here I'll type presentations and these are the various templates that are available to me. I'll simply click on any one that I desire or I like. I'll click on that. And this is not where the canvas ends. It will give me the various color combinations that I can choose. But I must make sure that I am only choosing the free versions. Because if it's a pro version, then for that I need to upgrade my Canva. And then only I can use those particular templates. So suppose I click this one. Then you can see that my PPTs are here. And it has quite a few number of PPTs. There are various pages here, right? So this is how we can make the presentations. Now let us start its editing. The first is the text. So I want to edit the text. I'll write lesson 1. I can write my name, or I can write the name of the subject, right? So this can be the first page. I'll move to the second page, and here I don't want anything like this. I want my students, I just want to say hello to my students because this is their first class in this flipped classroom version. So I'll delete all this, and what I'll do is I want to create an element. So I'll go to elements, and here you can see that there are various elements that I have recently used. I can select from them, or I can select any of the others. So let me select this phone and show you how we can make something interesting. Now here what I'll do is I want to insert my image in this phone, and then I want to say a hello to my students. So if I want to insert an image, I need to go to uploads. When I go to uploads, it asks me whether I want to upload an image or a video. I go to upload an image. I click on computer, or from wherever, if your image is there in Google Drive, you can click on that. My image is there on my desktop. So I'll just browse it, and I'll have my image. And if you want to delete any image from this library, you simply click on these three dots and you click to trash. So that image would be delete this, and then I will insert my image in the phone. Now you can see how this image appears. So what you have to do is, if you want to crop something, just click on that particular thing and go to crop, right? So your image would be automatically cropped. I'll click on done, and this is my image here. You can also go to these various color combinations that are there. So you can select the color combinations. So you can select these also. These are the various color combinations. You can also go to animate. So let me see this. So this is how it will come, or like this, or like this, right? Now let us go to elements. So in the elements, I have this. So I have brought it here, and I want to have something interesting. So what I'll do is I'll type here blob liquid. So when I type on blob liquid, you can see that you have various kinds of these blobs that you can insert in your presentation, and it will make it really interesting. So you can select these, and it would be inserted like this, right? So this is how it can be done. And let us move to the next slide, and you can edit this also, and you can insert various text, your chapters, your videos, music, whatever you want to add. So you can just try various options available. And what we can do is, we can either present it in the class if we are taking a live class, or we can simply download it. Now when I download this, the options that are available to me are, I can either download it as a PDF, or I can download it as a MP4, or I can download it as an image. So it's your choice whether you want to download it as a PDF or as a MP4. You can also download it as a PPT. If I go back, I can see that I can also download it as a PPT. But if I download it as a PPT, then all these animations are wasted. So I don't want that to happen, right? I will download it as a video, and this can be attached to your Google Classroom. You can have all your lectures made via this Canva, and then in Canva, sometimes there can be an issue that you won't be able to download the slides, because it would ask you to pay for it. Because when you include the elements or other things, then sometimes it's possible that it is not allowed for download in the free versions. So in that case also, you can easily do it, as you must have seen in the Google Classroom and Edmodo videos, where I made use of the PPTs using Canva. So in this case, when you are unable to download, what you can do is simply click on these arrows at the bottom and you will get a free, you will get a full screen for this. And here, if you are presenting your screen to the students using Google Meet or Geo Meet or Zoom, then you can simply show them this PPT there, or you can record it and then you can share it with your students. So there is no issue. Even if the PPTs are not downloadable in Canva, the other option is always available to us. Now let us see what else can be done using this Canva. Now we have created the presentations and the videos which can be uploaded to the Google Classroom. Apart from that, if we want to give certificate to our brilliant students, for that also Canva can be used. Go to home and here we can search for the certificates. Right, so I'll type certificates and you will get various options for the certificates. Obviously, some of them are free and the others can only be used in the pro versions. So I'll click any one of them and I'll get to know whether it is free or not. So this is a certificate. It can be, all the text can be edited. We can also put our logo here by going to uploads. We can also change the background, right? So if I want to change the color, this too can be done. We can go to background and we can change the background of the certificate, right? And we can just click on the text and that can be made editable. So if I want to click on this, I'll delete this and you can just write whatever you want to. You can change the font, the text color, you can change the font size or the font style. So you can make your own customized certificates for your students, and along with the badges that we gave them in the Edmodo, we can also actually give them the certificates so that the students are actually enjoying our classes and also complete their assignments on time. Now, if I go to home, all these certificates and everything that I have made would be automatically saved there. For that, I need to go to all your designs. So as soon as I go to all your designs, you can see how the certificate that I made, the video or the PPT that I made, this is a brochure, and the lesson plan, all are here. So you need not be worried that your designs would be lost. They are automatically saved to the Canva dashboard. I hope you like this video and you would be actually making use of all these lesson plans, presentations and videos in your flipped classrooms. Thank you so much for watching this video and enjoy the next session.